This video will show you how to use the Scenario Manager using information from Case Problem 1, Tutorial 10. In this case problem, you're given the situation that Professor Reynolds has 5 possible grading curves, and she wants you to evaluate which one results in a distribution of grades closest to her proposed distribution scheme that is given in the problem. I've already entered all of the formulas required for this to work properly, which are steps 1 through 7. So I'm going to just jump right into step 8, which is where we're actually using the Scenario Manager. So the first thing I'm going to do is go to my What If Analysis option from the Data Tools on the group on the Data tab and choose Scenario Manager. When my Scenario Manager dialog box opens, I'm going to click on Add. And here's where I can actually enter my scenarios. So my first grading scenario is going to be called Grading Curve 1. And then I'm going to change cells F4 through F8 to produce my resulting values. And press OK. Now I can actually enter the values for the lower range that I want. And you can see that it by default puts in the values that already exist in this range. And these are the values that I indeed want for my grading curve 1. And I can verify those from the list in my textbook in step 8. To add my next scenario, I'm going to click on Add again, and then this time I'm going to call it grading curve 2. My changing cells are going to remain the same, so I press OK. Now in my Scenario Manager box, I'm going to enter the lower values for each letter grade in the box given by the textbook. So we can see that the lower value for F is 0, for D it's 30, C is 50, B is 70, and A is 90. I can go ahead and press OK. If I move this out of the way and press Show in my dialog box, you'll see that my lower range is actually going to change and the values over in this area are going to change as well. I'm going to go ahead and add my next curve here, which is going to be grading curve 3. And again, I'm following all the same steps. Values given by the book are 50, 65, 80, and 95. And again, clicking on Show, you'll see all my values change throughout. So I'm going to go ahead and add the rest of my grading curve summaries very quickly here. So I can see I now have all of my summaries, and if I go through these very quickly, I can look at what my total difference is and see which one is closest. So I can see that for scenario 1, 50.91 is my difference. For scenario 2, it's 15.45. Scenario 3, 40.91. Scenario 4, 29.09. And scenario 5, 56.36. So obviously, scenario 2 is going to be the most optimal based on the scenarios that she provided. So now I'm going to create a summary report of all of the scenarios that are listed here. You can do this by clicking on the summary option and then choosing which kind of report type I want. I'm going to stick with a basic scenario summary, and then I'm going to choose the resulting cells. And in this I want to show the percentages that have changed for each value and the final difference. And press OK, and then you'll see my scenario report comes up here. So I can see what the values are in grading curve 1 through 5, and then I can see what the resulting percentages are, and the total lowest percentage here is actually scenario 2, so that is what I would choose.